Hello everyone, my name is Hagar, and for part one of the GAN power switching fundamentals videos, we will be going over GAN power switch nomenclature, types, and structure. In this video, we will briefly go over the benefits of GAN, GAN transistor nomenclature, the types, and a basic structure of GANFETs. GANFETs are now providing designers and customers with a practical and viable alternative to silicon MOSFETs in higher density applications. GAN devices operate faster with high-speed switching in the megahertz range, are smaller, allowing high power density systems, and are more efficient with lower switching energy and reverse recovery losses. When it comes to GANFET nomenclature, it is very similar to that of a silicon MOSFET. Just like the silicon MOSFET shown to the left, GANFETs also have a gate, source, and drain terminal. However, GAN power switches do not have a body diode as silicon MOSFETs do. GANFETs also have similar parameters and parasitic components, which we will be discussing in the parameter and design recommendation videos for GAN. Nowadays, the major commercial GANFETs are HEMTs, which stands for lateral high electron mobility transistors. These GAN switching devices come in two different types: eGAN, which stands for enhancement mode, and dGAN, which stands for depletion mode. An enhancement mode transistor is normally off and is turned on by positive voltage applied at the gate. A depletion mode transistor is normally on and requires the use of negative voltage applied at the gate to turn off. To allow normally off operation of a depletion mode GAN HEMT, it can be packaged in Cascode with a low voltage silicon switch. Here, the GAN FET is turned on and off by switching the silicon FET on and off in every cycle. TI's solution is to simply have the GAN FET driven directly, where the silicon switch is used as an enable switch at startup. So the silicon switch does not switch in every cycle, only the GAN switch does. We will now go over a basic example of a lateral structure of GAN FETs. In this structure, we have the silicon substrate, gallium nitride buffer, aluminum gallium nitride barrier, our three terminals, source, gate, and drain, a layer of passivation or a protective dielectric, as well as a field plate extending from the source terminal. GAN HEMTs require a passivation layer to reduce the effects of surface electron traps between the gate and drain contacts. The benefits of the field plate is an increase of the breakdown voltage and a reduction of the surface electron traps. The heterojunction of aluminum gallium nitride barrier and the GAN buffer, which is a type of junction between two different semiconductors, forms something called a two-dimensional electron gas, or 2DEG for short, and it has very high charge density and mobility. It is in this 2DEG channel that current flows, versus in a silicon MOSFET where the channel for current flow is the depletion region between the source and drain. We mentioned earlier that GAN FETs have no body diode. The body diode in silicon MOSFETs form from the p-n junction between the source and drain. However, we do not have said junction in GAN FETs, and that's why there is no body diode. More information can be found in these useful links.